So, back when this game first came out, if you're one of those people like me who got it early with the Digital Deluxe version 4 days before it actually came out for everyone else, I only saw gameplay of the Switch version for some reason. Now, granted, I know Sonic Colors was a Nintendo exclusive Sonic game, so I would see why they went out and bought the Switch version, but this game came out on all current platforms, including the PC, Xbox One, and PS4. Are these people so oblivious to the fact that it actually came out on all the other platforms that they went out and bought the Switch version? Like, I refuse to believe that everyone who owns a Switch does not own a PC or Xbox One or PS4, and yet the people that do think that it's okay for them to just go out and buy the Switch version and present all these glitches that it presumably has to get all these views and just end up giving Sonic a bad rep altogether. Like, why would you do that? I don't get these people. Like, I remember back in the Dreamcast days, granted, I wasn't born back in the Dreamcast days, but this man had respect. And they're just go out and treat my boy so dirty with this new port of Sonic Colors on the Switch and just wanna present all these glitches to these ignoramuses on the internet, these memers, and just makes me so angry. Why can't we just get along and just, like, yeah, the Sonic movie made this guy laughing stock, or wasn't Sonic or since that started that trend. Like, granted, that game is love, but yeah, we've had the Sonic movie. It just made me look even more like a laughing stock. Like, I still like it, but still. Guys, can we all just get along and just love Sonic? Like, we can hate Sonic, but we don't have to go out and act immature and just, like, poop on the guy all the time. Like, yeah, I've had some glitches on the PC version, but that doesn't ruin my overall love for Sonic Colors as a whole, and my experience on the new remaster. Just, I'm sorry, I should probably addressing that before starting this video. But, yo, what's up YouTube? 99's the name, Let's Play is my game, and today, I'm going to be presenting all the true finale of my 100% walkthrough on Sonic Colors Ultimate of the PC. I know I said 100% walkthrough, meaning that you think I've always been going for Game Land. No, I am not, because Game Land is boring. Game Land is for scrubs, and I don't really have anyone to play it with, so ha, ha, and ha! Today we're going to be going through the end show, which means that we're going to be basically going through every single level again, every single action stage, all 45 of them, mind you, and that's how we're going to be ending off this playthrough. And, I'm actually going to repeat what I did in my previous Let's Play of this game, where I'm going to be placing music over it while I'm setting up my gameplay, so that way you won't have to be listening to me blabber my stupid mouth out, and my stupid voice, and my stupid self, while I'm recording me going through every single stage again. So I figured, what's the point in doing that? You already saw me go through all the other levels and get all the red rings and get all the S-ranks and whatnot, so might as well play some music over, because that's how I did it last time. I want to carry on that tradition. So without further ado, perfect for jittery visitors with no attention span to spare on getting there. Now, I just noticed, last time I did the Edge Shuttle on the Wii version, it was very low quality, mind you, even though the Wii was still love, but I wasn't able to read the small text up there below the words Edge Shuttle. Because the quality was so low on the Wii, it says, Tropical Resort, Sweet Mountain, Starlight Carnival, Planet Wisp, Aquarium Park, Asteroid Coaster, Terminal Velocity. If anyone wants to challenge me on this game, they're welcome to do so. Well, that's what we're going to be here to do. And if y'all are hyped, hit that thumbs up, leave a comment what you thought, and don't forget to subscribe to stay updated. This will be the last video on my Sonic Colors Ultimate walkthrough. And yeah, I'm going to be going back to Skyward Sword and Wonder Woman Secret Worlds in the meantime. Oh, by the way, I'm also going to try to go for a no-hit run and a no-death run. Or if I don't get hit, then I shouldn't be able to die. But, I mean, I can fall down a pit and get revived by Tails. But that's besides the point. I'm going to try to go for a no-hit run, a no-death run, and I'm going to try to see if I can hunt down every single ring. Now, granted, I remember in Sweet Mountain Match 4 that you aren't actually able to do that with, like, the fourth red ring. Or the third one. I'm not sure, but I'm going to try to grab every red ring that I can, because they do give me a lot of pointage, and I want that pointage. But I'm rambling on. Without further ado, let's plow our way through the Edge Shuttle. Begin with Tropical Resort Act 1, and going all the way to Terminal Velocity Act 2. Let's do this thing!
Wrong and who is right. kill it, even win, take them out. This is justice, this is what's right. Here comes the enemy, mess them up. And bring them to the knees, do your stuff. Time for justice, time to go fight.
Well, that didn't go exactly how I planned. I mean, I got hit like, what, at least 3 times? How many times did I die? At least 1 time. And yeah, it was impossible for me to try to get every single red ring, but I got most of them. It's pretty good. Astro Coaster was still the easiest stage ever, but look at that. I got a total time of 121 minutes, 33 seconds, and 88 milliseconds, and my overall total score is 80,105,640. Look at that, that's the Tropical Resort. Here's Sweet Mountain. Starlight Carnival. Planet Wisp. Aquarium Park. Asteroid Coaster. And Terminal Velocity. And go set to Tropical Resort. But there we go, guys. The X Show has been completed. Thus marking the true finale of my Sonic Colors Ultimate walkthrough. Yeah, got the first one all clear, but still haven't put in my initials, shall we? It shouldn't take too long. Yeah, this game did not want me to keep my rings. I honestly did not expect it to be that hard, that easy to keep my ring, or just that difficult to keep my rings. Like, I know I'm pretty much a god at this game, despite all the mishaps that I had, but I mean, I still had fun. Like, this is still a really great and polished Sonic game and a very polished, port. So, that's only 65% of the world map completed. I know I still have to do Game Land, and I still have some achievements yet to complete, but as you did see, I was able to get that achievement to where I, got 2 hits on, what's his face, Captain Jelly, and I got Long Haul, which was for completing the X Show. I also got 99 Tail Survivors. I think I started at like 4 or 3, I don't even know. I think once you start the X Show, your Tail Rescues reset, and I got 99 of them. That's pretty impressive. I mean, give or take. But, none of those tokens that I got counted, so I was going to plan on buying something, but I'm not going to drag this thing out any further. So Sonic Colors Ultimate, I highly recommend it. Get the PC version. Don't be a scrub and get the Switch version, because if you're one of those people that has a Switch and always a PC, you do not exist. If you have a Switch, you have a PC. Get the PC version, you idiot. Then, anyway, that will wrap up today's video. I was joking, by the way. Thank y'all so much for watching my Sonic Colors Ultimate 100% walkthrough, even though I didn't do Game Land, but, Game Land sucks. If you enjoyed today's video, please just hit that thumbs up, leave a comment what you thought, and don't forget to subscribe to stay updated. And stay tuned for more of Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD and Wonderland Secret World, because I'm going to be moving back to those. Stay tuned for more adventure walkthroughs coming up as well. Stay positive and stay awesome.